I mean, like I said, it was Daytona, right? So fucking, you know, the leg won't bother as much as the other tracks. Like, it'll still be a problem, but it won't be as bad. Okay, I got my game started. Attack. We're about to start this here. The stream's up. The stream's up. Loser goes home.
You ready to go home?
Fuck you. One fucking yard. One fucking yard last time.
This Lion fan base have been craving home playoff football since this building opened in 2002, and they've got it today at Ford Field in Detroit.
But I went for it on fucking like a 4th and 12, and I got fucking 11 yards. Instead of fucking 12, I was 1 yard short of fucking making it.
And the Detroit Lions. Who will punch the fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round? We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon.
I probably should check my depth chart out fucking before this game started today, right? I'm gonna have to play. I'm the Lions, he's the Packers. Yeah, I gotta pause this in a minute.
They fake the give. Now
look at all the players in.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
You can only pause it like twice a day or something
like that. Midfield and
it's only one.
I was gonna make sure I got all the right players in.
I got some. I can't give you no from here. Any sign today? Hey. Here in Kentucky says somebody got killed by a Denny sign falling on them.
Damn. Well, Tag, you got a digital?
What?
You got the GT7 digital?
No, I got the.
Damn it.
He tries.
Oh, shit.
He's trying to get somebody to
get it for free.
If you gave your game share with each other.
Okay, I'm ready. Anytime you're ready to attack.
Yeah, me and my friend Sean, we share over 400 games together.
No.
Good first play by me.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And a good burst there right from the start as he'll get this one out near the 35. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
From the 35 on second down,
Rodgers.
Nearly an interception here on this opening drive.
That didn't come,
he gets a reprieve. It's third down. They tried to throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to 3 on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about just as you pointed out, not just giving up 3, possibly giving up 6. Let's see what they decide to do here because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
He said, if I owe you now,
nice
cheer.
He's got the first down inside the 10. And he will get this into the
end zone. I thought I had you back here for a minute.
Green Bay.
Aaron Jones
taking it in from 24 yards out. And the Packers are on the board first here in this division round matchup.
Oh, so laggy.
Crosby with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game.
Well, the money he's supposed to pay me never went
now
to my
now after the touchdown,
PayPal,
here's so. Crosby to kick it away.
Did you approve it on your thing?
How you do that?
Well, what are you doing on Cash App?
We'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
PayPal, you're supposed to just load it up, and it says, this person's trying to send you money. You know them. Push yes.
It never pop up. I got all my notifications on.
Well, even that doesn't really pop up notifications.
First carry for DeAndre Swift. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Who are you playing on this game,
always know that he is tough. I'm playing Kendall. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game,
stream,
reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball game.
Meanwhile, field throw taken in by Hockenson here. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good
mindset going in.
The discussion we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
How did J.D. lose to Tennessee?
He lost to Tennessee? Damn.
Here's second and 10. Now it's Fields off the bootleg. On the move to his left. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 38-yard line.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Fields tapping it forward, jet sweep. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Back to the running game with Swift.
Oh my God. What?
And he'll get into the end zone.
Good blocking, boys. Good blocking.
DeAndre Swift. 27 yards. And
I want
Lions
a pet turtle.
An extra point away from tying this thing up.
Oh.
Extra point safely through. And it will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play.
Looks like that's going to be a series.
Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Second and five. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones.
Fuck yeah.
54 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Fuck Adams. Fuck his shirt,
man. Press coverage on the outside. And for defenders, that's the ultimate risk-reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got to step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
Rodgers' throw is taken in by Jones. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And it's a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space. It turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Oh my God. I thought I fucking picked that for a minute.
A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Here's Rodgers to throw. He's got the tight end, Sternberger.
Fuck yeah.
And he's going to have a Packers first down. They needed another three. He doubled that. He got six.
Another classic.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy.
Ronnie Lott. Ronnie Lott.
Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get advantage that way.
Now a first down carry by
Jones. I tripped, man. Fuck on.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle on the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From the 29, Rodgers.
Fuck
outside, it's complete. He's got it. And they'll get this down.
You're gonna hear
10.
A lot of fucks going on tonight, boys.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
And of course he's running it.
Now Jones. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. A good run on first down, and now they contemplate a second and goal situation.
Natural lead called Swerve.
Rodgers now to throw. Escaping the pressure right to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
Three tight ends up front here, third and goal. Rodgers going to throw. And it's a Packers touchdown.
Good job.
A 2-yard touchdown.
Lineman touchdown.
And the Packers have taken the lead.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense.
I want to see a fat
when they're the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Oh, no, this is...
That's no good. He misses the PAT. So file that one away. Could eventually lose.
Lag is not working in my favor right now.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
I don't understand this at all.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 41-yard line.
Off play action. Fields is going to fire one deep middle of the field. And this one is incomplete. Well, Charles, you talk about this offense and you think about the man in charge, their head coach, this marking his first ever playoff game as the head coach, and you wonder what's going through his mind right about now.
Brandon, I think we both agree that he's had a great season, and we wouldn't be surprised at all to see him get plenty of Coach of the Year votes. I thought he took the right tone in his weekly press conference, though. Played it cool, took the reserved angle, and when you don't have the track record, I think that's the exact right way to do it.
Back to throw, Fields. And he'll work it across midfield.
He's a good kicker,
Yep.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Fields throwing again. Catch is made by Hawkinson.
Oh, I missed the hit. Shit.
Yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Too old, man. Oh, this fucking guy. Go to the middle. Yep, here we go. Oh, wide open. Here we go.
I gotta make some fucking. I gotta get some more well pack fucking plays here.
This opening quarter, and the Lions have tied it. If they hit the extra point, they'll have the lead.
I just fucking ran into it, fucking quickly.
And with it, his guys take the lead here by a point. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail here early in this division round game as they seek a spot in the NFC title bout. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run.
Do you know what team
he
plays for?
Now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Oh, a squad for the football, and he's going to come down with it.
Fuck, yeah.
Time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
Rodgers now on first down.
Shit! I saw him last second.
I thought he was going to break that for you.
We are in for a good
I tried to, but I couldn't do anything.
I just seen him.
Damn it.
Throwing on 2nd and long. Rodgers. And that's incomplete.
What the fuck you down into, Rodgers?
Because now you got 3rd and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to begin after. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
A perfect circle, and just threw it right out of bounds.
3rd down, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be 3rd and a mile.
Go low.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
Oh, my God.
O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Looking up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose.
That almost worked for it. What friends are for. Almost.
As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turned it over there. That's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that.
That's holding.
This is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it.
But right now, oh, come on, that wasn't out of bounds. I got hold on the freaking end of line. What the hell?
That one's good for 35 yards on the ground and a first down.
I can't stop this fucking Wildcat shit. Oh, what happened? What happened?
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked.
That's what it is. Oh, my God, bro. He fucking grabbed his arm. Why not going to be wide open?
Let's check in with the referee.
Fucking damn.
They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Swift. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Lions are able to extend their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is up to 8. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Under.
How are you doing, buddy?
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They punted last time.
Probably just going back like two quarters or something like that.
To make sure they don't do that again.
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down.
He definitely was out of bounds.
Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones.
And ooh, I thought he was gone for a minute.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 85 yards rushing for him now as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, it's Rodgers. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab.
Boy, that completion comes with a high degree of difficulty, especially on the catch. Had to look that one in one-handed, able to do so, and ends up picking up a first down as well.
On play action, now Rodgers. He'll buy some time right. And that drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 2nd quarter. On
First and 10, it's Swift. And he's going to get a solid game.
Like,
when
you try to do this, like, play online or the random match?
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Now a first carry for their fullback. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
Let's face it, you want
a team full of guys who get your first downs and big plays of all styles, but you've got to have a big man. You can just turn and hand it to, and he can be dependable in picking up first downs.
To the 23-yard line.
I can't even pick a goddamn play.
Second down, Swift. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
These were relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Here's Fields. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. And in for the Lions, touchdown. T.J. Hockenson, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Lions add on to their lead. Point after here, coming up.
About 10 minutes.
And the lead is up to 15 now. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
After Julian Sands is missing.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers.
Ah.
Middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on first and second
yeah,
down,
that's
bringing
why
third
looking...
and ten. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
And the throw there going to be incomplete. Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
A nice job getting free on the return for 13 yards. And the Lions will take over. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total. Alluding to... And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield.
Fuck, yeah.
The Packers pick it up. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. Oh, that's just not fair, and now room to run. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
On first down, Rodgers. Throw left side, taken in by Amari Rodgers. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Throwing is Rodgers. Man open right side. It's Rodgers. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
Fucking fumble.
Every now and then I can speak from experience because I do know, as a defender, it is awfully hard to stay with your man on these crossing routes because even if you don't get picked, there's a danger of being picked either by one of their receivers or maybe by your own defender. And on that play, that worked quite well.
And he's going to be taken down.
I legit pressed R1.
Ed Oliver, that time, the one to get in there and bring him down. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers finds the open target, Arnold. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Hey, let's face it. You can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left.
And this is caught.
He's coming back.
For the moment, it's a touchdown, nope. But multiple flags down, fuck. So let's sort this out. And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty, no question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty
would
do?
I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Fucking fumble. That was
extra point
so good.
Good by Crosby. And this is back to an
one
8-point
fucking
game. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. A play fake, now Fields to throw. Packer pressure, and down he goes. Kenny Clark busting through to get him for a loss of 6.
There you go, Bruins.
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. And all the way down to the 40-yard line. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. On the handoff, this is Swift. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift on his way to a historic performance. 4 first half touchdowns. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
Oh, shit, he's missed that.
And it's no good.
Fuck.
Oh, he misses the extra point, and our score stays right where it is. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
Come on, let me scroll down. I mean, I'm going to play. Jesus fucking Christ.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it when...
A leap in. He's got it. He got it. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 35 yards.
He was out of bounds. I can't even challenge that.
They might just review it either way. I don't think I got it. No? His foot definitely wasn't playing. Okay.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Arnold. This a second and seven from the 37.
This is definitely not the play I wanted.
To throw, it's Rodgers. Incomplete.
Well, to me, there is no question about the intent there, and I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on third down.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. To throw is Rodgers. Got a man able to find Rodgers. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds.
Couldn't get him down.
He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. Now Rodgers.
Why are you...
intercepted. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone, and the Lions are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own four-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So a costly penalty yardage-wise, as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man
or the ball, fucking fast.
If you're playing the man,
before
you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. So we've come upon halftime here, this NFC divisional round matchup, as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach, a trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they've been the better of the two teams through two quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium. But you know who was not a surprise to Farnham?
Yeah, that's true.
This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
152 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame as he is trying to will his guys to the championship round next weekend.
I can look after this. I can...
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Running is Swift, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football,
sure
getting
football
him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive
front because if they can't get upfield,
their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Then we have a doubleheader for the other league.
And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way
I would say abusive, but, you know, the rules are fucking much easier fucking so he can run better, right? Like,
mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Like, I'm not a fan of custom cautions, right? He'll have custom cautions and shit, yeah.
Throwing on third down, Fields going underneath. He's got Hockenson and able to pick up the first across midfield.
I've even seen it like in other leagues where there's custom cautions and it keeps it like one guy will spin out and dog him yellow caution right away, even though they weren't custom cautions.
But they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on
Manual custom.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. Here's a handoff to Swift. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
I mean, also, when you do that, you get guys jumping to start doing that, too.
Let's get
right
back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Now Fields. They'll roll him out right. He's got the first down here inside the 30. He is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Now, that was a whole lot of open space out in front of it, wasn't it? I'm telling you, Brandon, when things are going right, they are going right.
And everything has been going their way for the most part. I saw that lane start to develop. Boom, he took advantage of it. On first down, Swift, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
They're pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try to pound them into submission.
It's not in there. I'll post it in general after this game.
I don't see why that trend would change now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, fuck, you could have done it.
The last run good for 2. Yeah. Here's second and 8.
He just wants to race from over.
Fields. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. Give him 6 on the screen, but now it's third down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11.
They've definitely established a rhythm on this drive, moving the ball quite well. And big man with football is an integral part of the whole thing.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Now it's Fields. Right side, it's the tight end, Hockenson. That catch good for only a couple.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
That leads us to a 1st and goal. It's a pickup of 8.
And this is just a little touch pass. It's in the receiver in motion. Just kind of tap it forward to it. That doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down. A nice, consistent game.
It looks like a jumbo set with three tight ends here for first and goal. And they'll try to pound it in with Ricard. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Patrick Ricard punching it in from a yard away. And the Lions continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead.
He's not in a good mood.
And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21.
He isn't quit yet.
How does the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away? The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Here's Jones again on second down.
That was a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
That's why in the league we got real fucking looks out there. You can't do the same play over and over again. You got to go four or five plays before you do a play.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard. On second down, it's Jones. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six. Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long.
Yeah, my good, yeah.
There's Rodgers. Forced out to his left. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off around the 41. And he will bring it back.
You don't want to let this happen,
man. And return for the Lions touchdown. Well, you don't want to coach him, Charles, to stay in the pocket on every play, but I guess that's the danger of getting outside of the pocket, extending a play, and making a bad throw. Turns into 6 points the other way.
Yeah, sometimes when you get outside the pocket, your vision actually gets obscured a little bit, or you narrow it down too much, and you don't see all the defenders in the area.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll increase their lead to 28.
I'm going to play against fucking Scooter next week, and then the winner of that game goes to the Super Bowl.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Yeah, it's going to be Rooster or Neil Scooter. Rooster's making the final no matter what. It just depends if he's going to play Neil Scooter. Yeah.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And
I lost to JD
in
Midwest
six.
The playoff,
they've
man.
Got to forget about that 14-7.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, time. He's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long time.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
It's the fourth or fifth pick.
This D wanting to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Point after, right down the middle. And that will extend this big lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
Oh, that's what this clock
I like that, because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there. It's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game.
It's funny because he beat me fucking close to the other.
He is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass or run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. He finds his man. Complete. That's Arnold. And he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up, because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now it's Rodgers. Buying time to his left. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And that will be incomplete.
Well,
they weren't scared to
bounce.
Let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
So one first down on that drive, and that's it. Forced to take the deep shot on third down and couldn't hit it. Now they have to punt this one away.
And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football.
You just wait until this football.
The Lions offense
you just wait until
ready
this football
game is
done.
I get
on the fucking Discord.
They're continuing to rock and roll, and at intermission, you know, maybe sometimes you fear after such a good first half of a letdown, but that wasn't the case.
And what I remember most about being in those situations is exactly what you're talking about. You almost have that sense of satisfaction. You're like, ah, we're doing really well. But I remember one time someone saying, "Winning's fun, but so is playing really well. Why would we want to do otherwise?" That was the message to keep the intensity up, to keep things going. And I guess exactly what we're seeing here from this team.
Yeah, it's helped them extend their lead. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and 9 situation.
Oh, the game just ended or something. I think he just conceded. Yeah. You had to wait till the fourth quarter. He just fucking had to wait till the fourth quarter to start so he could concede. Well, what happened there? Fucking, did they show him any score here? Well, just let it fucking. No, but the game here fucking. That's what all happens. No, yeah. Yeah. They'll just give me the force when they go there. Oh, I'm actually get the win. Mm-hmm. would be the next dare, so probably would be the guy that dance it. Holy shit. Switch up place, spend a little money, don't care how it's made. Drop top, cool, catch sun ray. Start off with attic, gotta get it one day. Doing 200 on the runway. Got a bad chick, she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Rip out my heart, you're a demon. Yeah. I need the money for real reasons. Why everybody come through? Yeah, I seen that. I'm reading some messages. Wake me up, cause I gotta be dreaming. If only my dogs could see this. Never had no money. Oh, fucking, I know fucking how fucking Golden Drove was taking his cat, I mean, his dog to the vet and shit, but vets are expensive. Ooh, that sucks. He doesn't got the money, so fucking like the dog's probably gonna need surgery now. He doesn't got the money for it, so probably gonna have to put the dog down. I couldn't imagine doing that. Fucking like, it's gonna suck when I have to do it, right? But fucking, I mean, fucking my cat's fucking family, right? Like, I'll be in fucking tears. Like, I can tell you that now. You know what, I'm still reading some of the message from fucking, I'm just fucking reading some of the message about. For what? No, I don't think so, no.
Get no bread, yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels counting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. To get too tight, like on that with Danny, and they talking games. Like everything look cut them drop. They go insane, they wanna pitch. Ain't gonna get in the beef, I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. How that's your girl, and she in my rental. We hot cable, we ain't even have no channels. They change the channel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, B&E. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. That's my sweet, but I be switching it depending on the week. Christian Lou, red bottom, them I think I cut my feet. They talk about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all. Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty. Wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my wife to stop. He don't like to pass the ball. I wonder where that low is at. It was me against the wall. I was out here running plays. Guess it paid off after all. 13 bad girl. Her hat just got a star. She got it stitched and I got it stitches. We won't be sparing you. Chasing who? Pursuing who? I won't be chasing you. I'm 4-1. I lost the cap. I'ma charge it to the game. 4-3-8 is not a game. It's just a music thing. Last player got out his lane. Put right back in his lane. I'ma sit that pat when I get the cap.
I don't know what I forgot about that. I'm gonna turn it off now. I just fucking type shit on my phone.